week's edition of Campus Sport. Al-Ain, in the United Arab Emirates, the city whose name means the source in Arabic, originally an oasis with hot springs. Al-Ain now welcomes the fifth World University Championships in shooting. One of the competitors with the shotgun is Antonino Barilla, and he has an important goal this year.
Here is a very important competition. I did this competition three times, and this is four times that I do World Championship University. And I won the last World Championship in Kazan 2012, so I am here for defense my title.
A silver medalist at the World Championships in Granada this year, he competes in the double trap, the newest discipline in shooting. It consists of using a shotgun to shatter two clay targets fired into the air simultaneously.
I started shooting in 2005, like in competition. I was in the high school, and when finished, I started university. And till now, I'm university also shooter and student.
A student in engineering. Somehow, he has to divide his time.
Not easy to do everything together, because for study you have to take a lot of power, a lot of concentration, a lot of time. And the same for shooting if you do this like professional. So it's very, very difficult, but it's not impossible. I did, so it's possible.
To be a good shot, you need a good eye and steady hands. And of course, you need confidence. But nothing comes for free. As with every sport, training is a part of life.
A lot of time I finish to shoot and I go to gym, or I go to run or aerobic work. Physical training is very, very important for every sport and also for shooting. Because it's not enough only shooting in the range, but training physical in gym. And it's good because I have always the under control my body.
Shoulder exercises to avoid the pain, and balance and core muscle exercises are at the heart of his training in the gym. It's really important because it gives the serenity and the tranquility the shooter needs in a difficult situation. When the shooter is getting a zero score, because it does happen, like a goalkeeper can let in a goal in football, but when he scores zero, there's some disorder in the mechanism of his mental system. And so what we're trying to do is get the shooter to be mentally and physically prepared and to help him to overcome difficult situations.
Mentalmente pronto e fisicamente a posto, questo gli permette di superare il momento di difficoltà.
Shooting requires physical skills like stability, coordination, and endurance. But there's more. During competitions, mental skills are fundamental.
Final, semi-final, during important shooter, and you have to be very, very quiet. But in the same time, you have to be very aggressive, very power, very strong to catch the target. So it's the good balance of this quality.
Unfortunately, during the final, Antonino was not at his best. He wasn't able to keep pace with his teammate.
I go outside from a gold medal match and I shoot for bronze, but my condition bad continue because in five targets I miss four and after lose. But it's good competition for training myself because my last important competition is in 1 week and a half to Azerbaijan for World Cup final.
In the final, the shooters are eliminated one by one until just two remain on the range. In the double trap final, Alessandro Chianesi from Italy was up against Mohamed Al-Sawaidi from the United Arab Emirates. No gold here for Antonino, but it would go to his Italian teammate, Alessandro. From the shotgun to pistols and rifles. In pistol and rifle competitions, the athletes shoot indoors at electronic targets. In the 25-meter rapid-fire pistol, they have a series of five shots each in a limited period of time. Six competitors will go through to the final. And this year, it will be a French medal sweep. Boris Artaud finishing third, Jean Quicampois, with a score of three in the last round, would finish second. And the winner, Clément Bessaguet, in the lead since the third series of shots, and he would finish with a nice five. So a word from the man who came second, Quicampois of France. In the match, I really wanted to prove what I could do. I was really hungry for it. I had just one wish. I wanted to win. Well, I was second. He was first. Everybody's happy, but I really did want to win the final. The 25-meter pistol for women and a final between a young Korean and a Mongolian. To reach the gold medal match, Kim Ji-hai had to survive a shoot-off. Now, she'd be under pressure right the way through the final. But she held on. And she'd be the winner, finally. I was too nervous, really. I was very stressed. I had some tension and a pain in my shoulder. But you know, I enjoyed every moment of the competition. The Korean team was very strong this year and is looking forward to the Universiade in their own country, in the city of Gwangju, in 2015. The 10-meter distance sees different weapons come into play. The air pistol or air rifle, not with bullets, but lead shot. In the gold medal match, two Polish women who'd already won junior European medals. And with two tens, Joanna Tomala took the title.
It's my first time here and I won. It's amazing.
In Granada, Nicola Mazurova from the Czech Republic won her place at the Olympic Games in Rio. And she was probably the favorite here. But the Italian, Elania Nardelli, was a tough opponent. It would only be decided after the final shot, when Eliana would score a nine, that Nicola secured the match by a margin of 0.2.
Good start to the final. I didn't shoot nine, and I made a really good job in my shoot-off. And after that, I wasn't so nervous, and I was able to do a really good job.
In rifle competitions, to help keep them stable, athletes wear heavy pants, jackets, and shoes. The 50-meter three position is a discipline where you start in the kneeling position, then prone, and finally standing. In the women's contest, this is Nicola Mazurova again, the winner of the 10-meter discipline, competing once more for the gold. This time, however, the German Isabella Straub was just too good.
It was really close, and I knew it because she shot really good, and I was really nervous because of that, because if it's close, you know, the heart beats like you run 1,000 meters, and yeah, it was great.
The shooting here was just one of many university championships in a variety of sports that have taken place around the world this year.
It is very positive for us to go to new countries where we have never done World University Championships before, and you can already see that there's an excitement about our events going there. So this is also very positive for us. in championships, but also for FISU itself, because FISU is very much linked, of course, with education, with university students, and this is very important for us. So it opens up many perspectives for the future, and we're happy about that.
And FISU's next University World Championships in shooting will be staged in Mexico in 2016.
Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders. When education meets sport and culture, what best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.